Because Donny doesn't wear tassels, and you said you wanted to look like him, so we're going to take them all off. There we are.
Tell you what we could do as well is actually put these on, sort of create a kind of Donny wig.
Oh, yeah.
He used to be Beatles there, and so he could actually begin to look a lot more like Donny. If you keep your head still a minute, Gordon, I can try and balance these.
They look great.
Looks great, Gordon.
Very nice.
There
we are. All right. Donny's just saying how much he enjoyed part one of Double Dare. You ready for part two?
I am.
Here it is.
No challenges for you this time. Just sit back and...
Pre-tumbled everything.
You've pre-tumbled everything. We gave the boys a rest this week and you've been spinning the old tombolas all morning. Yes. Thanks very much, Donny.
No problem.
Kept you nice and busy.
Yes.
Well, let's go straight to our first question that was set a few weeks ago. And it was our Freddie Mercury competition. And the question was... Well, what we wanted you to do was to find your ideal video vote panel. Your ideal video vote panel. Now, this is not the one that we have to pick out now. Okay. This is the one that's on the little one that we've already chosen.
This is fun.
And he's taking it. It's the Donny Osmond show, and he knows what to do, and it's all brilliant.
Well, then I want to pick a winner. Okay.
All right, then. Well, they're all here. I've got some runners up here of people who you thought would make ideal video vote panels. Anne Chiron, for example, she lives in London. She thought Cleopatra, Henry VIII, President Gorbachev, and our PE teacher, Mrs. Margotson, would make a good pop panel. I must just give you this one here. This is very, very clever. This is Alistair Waugh, and he thought that his four people would be Leonardo da Vinci to judge inventiveness and design.
That's good.
George Lucas to judge film technology.
That's good.
Richard Branson to judge marketability.
That's good.
Right, hey? And last of all, Steve Wright to judge musical talent. Funniest of all.
That's good.
To say, that didn't quite make the winning one. In fact, Donny has got the winner, haven't you?
You've got the name of the winner in your leather jacket there. You want the name?
Yes, please.
Elaine Kenny from... I don't even know how to pronounce that.
Midlothian.
She's 11 years old.
And her four were over
four
here.
Four were Black Adder. Attila the Hun.
Yeah. Spanish, Atilla, I suppose you could
Atilla,
say. But he
right,
wasn't,
right.
Unfortunately. So Attila
the Hun.
Yeah.
Queen Victoria and Patrick Moore.
Thank you very much, Donny. That's beautifully done. Well done, Elaine. Now let's have a look at what Elaine will win. Over here. Simon is demonstrating this beautiful, unique set.
Where did you
designed
find Simon?
By Bryce Wormsley. He comes with the territory. Designed by Bryce Wormsley. This is a unique model, none other like it. You can take this home and have happy fun for hours playing with the models of Freddie and Monty, otherwise known as Freddie Mercury and Montserrat Caballé. Thank you very much.
Very good, Simon.
Now we can move on to the tombola, which we're dying to have a go at here. Now, the question was, it was our primetime TV competition, and the question was, where and when was the world's first high-definition television broadcasting service started? And the answer was, 2nd of November, 1936, Alexandra Palace. Donny, who's won it?
Daniel Walker in Bradford.
Well done, Daniel.
All right, Daniel.
And Daniel's 11 as well. And let's have a look.
He gets so many TV.
We're going to see now exactly what Daniel has won.
All right.
Over there, again, the lovely Simon is demonstrating the real size of this beautiful mini television. You can see a high-definition picture there, even though it's smaller than the average transistor radio. Thank you, Simon. Now let's move on to the next tombola over here, which is the compact video quiz.
Okay.
And the question last week was, what are the freezing and boiling points of water on the Fahrenheit scale? The answer is, of course, 32 degrees freezing, 212 degrees Fahrenheit boiling point. And let's see who's won.
Claire Morgan in Newcastle on Tyne.
That's the one. Well done, Claire.
All right, Claire.
Let's go and see what Claire wins. Look at this.
Wait, no, this isn't Simon. Who's this?
This is the lovely Trevor. The lovely Trevor is demonstrating a series of spooky games so you can have Halloween fun all year round. Thank you very much, Trevor.
Very good, Trevor.
And well done, Claire.
I like Simon better.
Last but not least, you'll like this next bit. The then Jericho question was this. Donny, let's see if you can get the answer to this without even looking at it.
Put me on the spot.
Then Jericho asked, in what book of the Old Testament do the walls of Jericho come tumbling down? Donny, a question for you.
Don't put me on the spot.
Joshua, the book of Joshua.
Joshua.
The book of Joshua. Yeah, well done. Now, let's see who's won and got the right answer. Good Lord, this is whole letter here. But it is from...
Philip, his name
Sue,
is... Oh, no, no. It's a, Sue Dimmock.
Sue Dimmock from...
From...
Littleworth. I do believe, aren't they, the Littleworth Crusaders are in this morning. I hope that's not fixed. Now, let's see what Sue has won. Now, the lovely Simon is modelling this casual, but sporty flying jacket, suitable equally for the aviator and trendsetter alike, complemented by this rather smart Ben Jericho hat. Thank you, the lovely Simon, and of course the lovely Treasure. And well done to all our competition winners this morning. And thank you, Donny, just welcome. For the moment.
Do I get one of those hats too?
We'll have to speak to Ben Jericho about that. We've only got the one. It's a bit mean. Coming on, expecting prize as well. See you later, Donny.
Okay,
thanks very much for the moment. Right. Now, we always have lots of interesting people, as you know, like Donny and the lovely Trevor and Simon, popping into Studio 7. And Pepsi and Shirlie were brave enough to come into Studio 7 on one of our very first going lives. And they had news of a fabulous competition. Well, the lucky prize winners were Vicky LeMond and Jane Bowen. And their prize was an all-expenses-paid trip to London, where they would get to choose some beautiful party clothes to attend the launch of Pepsi and Shirley's new album. And there were some more surprises for them on the way. Look at this.
This is West London. And this is a very posh hotel. And last night, our Pepsi and Shirlie winners stayed here. And today is the day they go out for their shopping trip. And they are a little bit late. Oh, a wasp. There's a lot of wasps in West London.
Hello.
I'm Jane.
Jane?
And I'm Vicky.
Vicky, right, how are you? All right. Oh, and these are mums.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
Right, you all set for your shopping spree?
Yeah.
Right, there's only one way to get a car in London. Have you over here, please? You see? It works every time. Right, I'll be the chauffeur. I'll be your chauffeur. So, ladies, if you would like to step into the car.
Thank you.
I think one mum in the back and one mum in the front. Yes, you. I'll let you go in the front. You can have pride of place. Anyway, on you go. All right?
Thank
you. Good. You don't shut the door. I shut the door. I'm the chauffeur. God, dear me.
Party!
Right, the moment has arrived. All you've got to do now is pick the clothes, okay? Yeah, all set?
Yep. Yeah.
Off you go and pick away. The store is yours.
As soon as Sarah had announced I'd won, all our neighbours rushed round to congratulate me. It was great.
I'm 15 and I've never won anything else before. I couldn't believe it when Sarah read out my name. I was so excited.
You just go back now to change into your stuff for tonight in your very posh hotel, nice and swish. I'll just go and find a tree trunk to change behind or something, okay?
Okay.
Okay. While I went off to find a suitable tree, guess who was waiting for the girls in their room?
Right, so I'll do Vicky.
And I'll do this young lady here, Jane.
Ta-da!
Now, who would have believed it? Pepsi and Shirlie are doing the girls' makeup.
Should we just go for it then?
Yeah.
Just remember, I've never done this in my life before.
Neither have I, but it's not something we've always
Look
wanted
up.
To do.
All right, finished.
Okay, can you look up?
All right, keep looking up. You're too young to use this. This is after a late night you use this stuff.
I had a bit of a snigger here. I think she's organised herself for the evening.
Like, I made all this myself and I glued all the things in. And I think I must have glued the lid together. Anyway, back onto this colour.
I might do actually.
Close again. Well, this is hard to do this bit. I do it on myself.
I'll take some more, because I know what you mean. You prefer it more like this.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll take some of that black off. In fact, I should do that now. Hold that. Taking off the tissue. Okay.
Close your eyes.
It's very kind of matte and not shiny and hot.
Right, I'm going to put some blush on, so you have to do this, smile like this, to get your cheek. I always used to suck my cheeks in, but every makeup artist looks good, so you just do that. So.
Still need to rub it just in the
That's why you have to apply it, and everyone thinks you're happy when you're doing it. Right, I'm going to put a bit of eyeliner on.
Now, are you looking forward to this evening?
Yes.
Are you nervous?
A little bit, yeah.
Don't worry, it's going to be great tonight.
Miss Victoria Lemon and Miss Jane Bowen. In the
street. Vicky!
Jane!
How are you?
How's it going?
Hi.
Hello. Hello.
He's a smoothie.
You are.
We're having a great time.
Who have you met?
Errol Brown.
From Hot Chocolate?
Yeah.
Do you know Siobhan? This is Siobhan May. She did first week.
Yes.
Well, they're filming here as well tonight, so
yes.
They'll be filming you being filmed.
Oh, yes. Brought me earrings out for a trip.
You have to go and meet some more celebrities now. Let's see if we can find you some more. Who else is around?
Hello. Hello. Well done. Where's Gordon?
That's what I asked Philip. He said he's not allowed to come to the show tonight.
I phoned up the BBC1 to complain because Gordon wasn't on one night. I did. I phoned up there in the children's department and they said he's gone on holiday. I said, you can't tell me that. I'm a grown up.
Gentlemen, please welcome the hostess for the evening, Pepsi and Shirlie.
What a busy day. Good day, though.
Yeah, it's been the best day of my life.
Yeah, it's been really good.
Ah, thank you, Pepsi and Shirlie, for offering such a wonderful prize for the two girls there, for Vicky and Jane. I know they had a wonderful time, and Philip enjoyed it as well. Well done, everybody.